professor Jola Bielski, de distinguished guest van de World and Israel, and a special, and I will start again in a minute, Mr. Obermanov. Professor Liora Bielski, a distinguished guest from abroad in Israel, and a special welcome to two of my dear friends, Professor Walter Verhaert of the Vrije Universiteit of Amsterdam and Mr. Alfred Hammerstein, chairman of the Dutch Art Restitution Committee. Special thanks to Liora for inviting me to speak at the opening of this important restitution dialogue. It may be unusual at the opening of a conference like this one to speak about deep disappointment and sorrow of what is going on now in the 21st year after the Washington Declaration. The Declaration was signed by 47 countries. Only 6 countries took legal steps for returning looted Jewish art during the Shoah. Strict legal laws for returning looted art during the Shoah made it virtually impossible for any private person to claim his rights without paying high legal expenses, which naturally almost none of the survivors had. Every painting that was returned was accompanied with great publicity, making the public impression nationally and internationally that looted art in this country was being returned. However, most of the claims which were honored came from descendants of art dealers who had found some registration of the art business before the war. Here at the Tel Aviv University Law Faculty, and many of you are lawyers and jurists, however, the return of looted art is more than anything else a moral question. The governments, the museums, and collectors are not the owner of the looted art. The looted art belongs to those who have perished in the German gas chambers and concentration camps. In Holland, Jewish homes were emptied by the Germans with the active help by Dutch collaborators. An inventory of whatever was confiscated, you know, they came to the houses and emptied the houses and the people were taken to concentration camps. However, when it came, they wrote everything down, every piece of furniture, every chair, every kitchen utensil, and when it came to paintings, they only read painting without description or name of the painter. The houses of the dead candles of my grandfather and my great-grandmother were empty this way. Most of the paintings and artworks were directly shipped to Germany. What do you think can have any recollection of what was in their parents' house? Most of the survivors were children, and it's far away, but they will not, and as far as they were not children, their parents had to build a new life and fight for the return of their belongings and business, and indeed many of these elder people failed, and the process of restitution of art took tons of years to start. No wonder, so, that the director of the National Rijksmuseum of the Netherlands, Mr. Taco Diggins, declared last week in Brussels that he has 7 provenance researchers and 100,000 paintings and objects which are suspect of Jewish origin. Although he claimed that reports about stolen art are published on a regular basis, we still have to find out who saw these publications. In the same meeting of the Judiciary Committee of the European Union Parliament, the German Swiss lawyer, Lorenz J. Nathan, told the members of the EU Parliament that just one German museum alone in North Rhine-Westphalia has 1 million paintings and artworks who have never carried out provenance and naturally nobody knows if it ever will happen. The well-known Anna Weber Chair, Commission of Looted Art in Europe based in London, stated at the same meeting that Italy and Poland flatly refused to return any stolen art during the war. And here I make a short introduction. I would like to welcome here Professor Beller. I heard he was the head of the panel at the European Parliament. And I heard the summary of what he said at this panel, and I was very much impressed. And I hope today to hear the same kind of voice. A couple of weeks ago, a couple, couple of weeks ago, the Baron Arcusin. Okay. A couple of weeks ago, the Baron Arcusin announced that it sold the most valuable painting of the Görlitz collection, a painting by Manet, to Japan for 4 million euro. The reason given was to cover the expenses the museum incurred in provenance and exhibitions in respect with Görlitz collection. If already now, 4 years after the Görlitz collection was donated to the museum, such an important painting was sold to Japan, it's absurd to think that the rich city of Bern and even richer government of Switzerland need this 4 million euro to maintain looted art by the Nazis. If this reasoning is being accepted, we can be sure that the Bern Museum, and likewise others who will keep looted art, will constantly sell looted art. Not to forget, Switzerland has been and is still one of the countries where art can be brought to the private auctions without provenance. According to well-founded publications, thousands of tainted paintings are still held in Swiss bank vaults. I have been today invited here as a Holocaust survivor, active on restitution of stolen art. The restitution of rock art during the Shoah is an upsetting story of deep distress and sorrow. Before I will tell further about the facts of art restitution, I just want to say in order to avoid the wrong personal impression. I speak here out, not out of resentment. I am today 91 plus, four sons and 11 grandchildren who all live in Israel. Having come to Israel in 1946, I have been able to create a good life for my late wife and family. Luckily, I never really nor received any restitution whatsoever from the Dutch government. And on this occasion, I'm pleased to invite the guest of this conference tomorrow evening at the home and see for yourself. I can only try to tell how deeply shocking is the present situation of looted art restitution. Since the Washington Declaration, only a fraction of the looted art has been returned. Many countries have yet to assign a single artifact. European countries like Germany, Holland, Belgium, and France, and also Israel, are actually holding up the return of hairless looted art. A year ago, took place in Berlin a big conference of 20 years after the Washington Declaration emphasizing provenance and restitution of art. Attention was specially given to the bullet case. Fortunes are spent on fruitless provenance research, congresses, meetings, conferences, lectures, and so on. Only last month, discussions took place in Brussels, Paris, and Milan. Looking at the result of this conference, this attendance of representatives of many countries, I, as a Holocaust survivor, can only say that the whole process at this stage seems useless. Looted art will stay with its unlawful owners forever. We discussed about half a year ago the return of hairless art in Germany with honorable and highly esteemed Minister of Culture, Dr. Monika Grütter. The minister told us that the German government decided that hairless art will presently not be returned and not put at anybody's hand, as there might be still private claims today and might be in the future. This cannot be the real reason, because it will be always possible to claim. Till today, no country in the world has taken any steps as to the fate of hairless art. In Switzerland, private auction houses who were very active in and after the World War II in selling looted art from Nazi Germany, sales without provenance is still a flourishing business for today. Last but not least, our Israeli museum refuses to return looted mosaics from the Jewish Historical Museum in Amsterdam during the Holocaust. To finalize, I come back to the subject I have been asked to speak about, the Washington Declaration. The Declaration, paragraph 9, states, if the private owners of art that is found to have been confiscated by the Nazis or the Hells cannot be identified, steps should be taken expeditiously to achieve a just and fair solution. I asked this conference and I asked the public poll, where and when will be this fair solution? And I can tell you, nobody in any country in the world talks about heritage art at all. For sure, it's much easier morally and legally not to activate this paragraph and keep polluted art till the last one who can testify on actually felt and seen the routine, will have died and then to decide who legally answers Shoah victims' property. Morals are not a factor. One more personal remark. This important conference will also deal with looted body and art and the cultural conflict between Israel and the Palestinians. Let me make it clear. There is nothing in the history of mankind like the Shoah, and any comparison will and must fail and isn't appropriate. Thank you for your patience and attention.